closing in on game time at Wrigley Field. The Cardinals and the Cubs, next on the show. It's been 100 years of baseball and counting at this place, and the charm hasn't faded a bit at venerable Wrigley Field in Chicago. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Chicago Cubs. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here for this NL Central Division matchup. I'm joined in the booth by longtime big leaguers Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. Before we get to them, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting St. Louis Cardinals, as manager Mike Matheny will line his guys up this way. On the mound to face these guys, one of the more consistent left-handers around, as you see the numbers there for the former All-Star John Lester. Matt Carpenter will move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight.
St. Louis, third baseman number 13, Matt Carpenter.
All right.
And he swings on the first pitch as this is popped high into the air on the left side. LaStella is there, and it's a first pitch out to start the ball game. So Lester off to a good start, and with that, let's take a look at the Cubs' alignment on defense. It's brought to us by the folks at Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. And now the second pitch of the inning is in the air to right. There to pull it in is Soler, and there are two away. Matt Holliday will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. First pitch of the at-bat is lifted in the air out to left. Coughlin will wait on it, and he will put it away to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. It's the Cardinals nothing. Cubs coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Now there you see Dexter Fowler, as he'll be the one to commence the action in the bottom half of the first. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. Pitch on the way. Swing and a ball sliced foul into the seats down the left field line. Now here it comes. And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one. Starlin Castro will be the batter. First pitch coming from Wainwright. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Now here's the pitch. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. A ball and two strikes now to the 2014 All-Star.
And now as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. He'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away. Anthony Rizzo will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. Hit softly to the right side. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Matt Adams will start us off in the second inning, and I believe, Steve, patience ought to be the watchword here.
Yeah, down on three pitches in the first inning. That's making life a little too easy for him out there.
Now Lester's 0-1. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. O-2 now from Lester. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. So the base is empty here with one away. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina.
Molina.
Oh, now a ball headed for the alley in right center, and on the first pitch of the at-bat, it's going to find that alley for extra bases. Here's Molina around first. He'll try for two. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
I'll get him now.
Batting sixth.
So a runner aboard at second here with one away. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Johnny Peralta. Now the first pitch here from Lester. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Lester ready, the 1-0. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. And nobody can get there in time. Base hit. And the run will score as the Cardinals are on the board first. It's 1-0. Colton Wong will stand in with a run in, one out, and one on here in the inning. First offering on the way. Not his best effort that time. It's strike one.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Comes set, now the pitch. And oh, look out! Up and in and nearly took his head off. You worry a little about things snowballing from here?
Well, you know, these are two teams that don't traditionally care for each other too much, so we've seen this go south before.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away. John Jay will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And there's the good fastball from Lester as he jumps ahead. No balls and a strike.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. One on its way from Lester. Fooled him a bit as this is hit high in the air towards right center and shallow. And here's Soler to make the grab, and that will end the inning. Jorge Soler will start things off in the bottom of the second. Here's the first offering. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Now here's the pitch. Boy, that's just about in the catcher's glove there. It's 0-2.
A lot of people think that pitch will burn straight down, but it will work back a little bit towards righties, like that one did right there.
Another 0-2 now from Wainwright. The 0-2 is a breaking pitch taken for a ball, 1-2.
That trying to go front door with that breaking ball started it a little too far inside, though.
Fouled back. Here's another 1-2. Stays alive here as this is fouled off to the right. He'll try again, 1-2.
Here we go.
Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number one. So one away here with the bases empty, and stepping in now is the catcher, Miguel Montero. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. Montero waits. Now the pitch. Ah, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2.
Part of the reason why you win 20 games? Well, you don't give up the long ball. And Wainwright last year, just 10 home runs allowed in 227 innings. That's the best ratio among starters in the National League.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away. Chris Coughlin will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Now the pitch. Hit hard but fouled off to the left, and that'll keep you honest as a third base coach. We're in the second with the Redbirds holding a 1-0 lead. Breaking ball swung on and grounded to second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Adam Wainwright will turn right around and get us started here. 9-1-2 to start inning number three. Now here's the first pitch. And Lester back to work as this is swung on and missed for the first strike.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
Ani takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two.
Hey, give him credit up there. He's going to take his hacks.
A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2. The 1-2. And this is swung on and missed for strike three. And adding insult to injury, that pitch hit him as well, but there's one away. Matt Carpenter will dig in. He popped out his first time. First pitch coming. Fouled straight back. Here it comes. And look out as this bat shatters on impact. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two. Jason Hayward will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Way off balance hack that time. Good for the first strike.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one. And that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Especially starting off an at-bat.
Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. Down in order go the Cardinals, but they're on top 1-0. Javier Baez will come forward to begin the inning. 7-8-9 to start the home third.
And they're still searching for a base runner. It's been 6 up, 6 down to start the game.
Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, but he will come on strong out there in right and pull this one down for the first out. Tommy La Stella will step in now. Now the first pitch. And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Grounded fouled off to the right side. The pitch. On a big curveball is in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone. John Lester will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Yeah, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Now he takes something off there as this is skied out to deep center field. Jay is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Matt Holliday will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
The left fielder number 7, Matt Holliday.
Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. And that is a fair ball as this one's heading for the left field corner. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Matt Adams will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now the first pitch here from Lester. Oh, and Montero can't squeeze it as it gets away. But he's safe at first as he gets back in time. One run, two hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. Now Lester's 0-1. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land foul just shy of the wall. 0-2 now from Lester. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now another 0-2. Way outside. 1-2.
And you know, down there at third base, he absolutely wants another shot at a ground ball. Something to try and make up for that error.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
And after the error on that previous play, I think he's out there saying, you know what? Why don't I just take care of this guy myself? Good job out there to bounce back with the strikeout.
Now here's the first pitch. Yadier Molina comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Hayes leading toward second.
Lester ready, the 1-0. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Here's the 1-1. And he gets under this one and, in fact, breaks his bat as this one's popped up. Oh, and he misses it. And the throw will go to second as they get the force out. Johnny Peralta will stand in. An RBI single in his first appearance. Now the first pitch. Hard hit to third. He'll go to Baez at second for the force, and that ends the inning. Dexter Fowler will be the one to lead it off when we come back. Dexter Fowler will stand in to begin their half of the fourth with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ballgame.
And still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
Back on the hill is Wainwright now as he jumps ahead of the leadoff man, nothing and one.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
And he's retired here, one away. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And to this point, these two have topped out at 95 and 91 miles an hour, respectively. Starlin Castro comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. And a good two-strike breaking ball there, but this will wind up missing. It's 1-2.
That big curveball is not an easy one to take on an 0-2 count. That's a great job of holding on.
Here comes a 2-2. And he got him. Anthony Rizzo will stand in here hoping to pick up his club's first hit in the contest. And this pitch is right down the middle, strike one.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. A scoreless half inning there from Adam Wainwright, and he's got himself a 1-0 lead.
Second baseman, Colton Wong.
First pitch coming. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. And the pitch. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth. John Jay will try it again. He flew out his first time. First pitch to him. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Adam Wainwright will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. That's out to left. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? You bet he does. 11 in a row set down, and the inning is over. Jorge Soler stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Adams is over, and he's got it for the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And stepping in now is the catcher, Miguel Montero. And this is going to be a foul ball. Montero waits. Now the pitch. And this is swung on and missed that time by Montero. No balls and two strikes now.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2. And there's the good curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Chris Coughlin will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. Pitch on the way. And you can put those no-hit thoughts away as this is into right field for their first hit of the ballgame.
Well, he'd had some high-stress innings here so far. It was looking like he turned a corner and was on his way to a much-needed 1-2-3, but he's going to have to get in the stretch here after all.
Grounded foul off to the right. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Yeah, one pitch away now from getting through 5 shutout innings. And I'll tell you.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike 3, and that will retire the side. Matt Carpenter will get things started here in the top of inning number 6. Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. Here's the pitch. Oh, he can't hold on there as he swings and misses on a pitch in the dirt, and he's down 0-2 now.
There you see one of the best swings in baseball look pretty ugly. That's what this guy can do to you.
Struck him out, but he'll try for first on the drop third strike. And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out. Jason Hayward will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And quickly, two are gone now here in the visitors' half of the sixth. Matt Holliday will stand in, 0-2 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one. Well, for that man right there, only the one run allowed. How discouraging is that when you're pitching your heart out and you're just not getting the support?
Well, the good pitchers really don't let it get to them. They know that it cuts both ways. Sometimes you give up 5 runs and your guys score you 8. You just have to focus on holding up your end.
And sorry to interrupt, but the play has been made for the third out. Inning over. Tommy La Stella will come in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first 5 innings have not been particularly kind to them.
And I think that's putting it mildly. Just one hit in these first 5 innings, they're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Way outside, 1-2. This is offered at in the dirt for strike 3. Just needs to make that easy throw to first. Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number 1. John Lester is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike 1.
And I wish more guys would pitch like this. I mean, look at that pitch count right there. That is really low for this stage of the game, and it's because he's throwing strikes and challenging guys.
Here's the first offering. Dexter Fowler is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Down and away, it's a ball and 2 strikes.
Yeah, that's the put-away curveball.
Oh, sorry to interrupt, but that's the third strike and the third out. Side is retired. Cubs are down in order. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Matt Adams will come forward now to begin the 7th inning in what's been a very briskly played ball game here tonight.
That's what happens when you get 2 starters that are on top of their game. It's been great pitching, great defense, not a lot of base runners, and a very even game through 6 innings.
Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. 1-1 on its way from Lester. A good action on the 2-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Real good lateral movement on that 2-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that. So just keep on throwing.
Got him. One gone for the Redbirds in the 7th. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball 1. And now a pitch on the way. Oh, that's wide, 2-0. Now here it comes. 3-0 now.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
Here it comes, the 3-0. And he won't even have to take the bat off its moorings. A four-pitch walk here.
Now batting.
So a runner at first now with one away. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Johnny Peralta. First pitch on the way. And now the bat explodes as this has popped up. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now Lester's 0-1. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Ready now on 1-1. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here's the 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Here he comes on 2-2. Now a rocket deep down the line in left. And this will get by him at third down the line. It's a fair ball.
And the way their starter's throwing, another run here, that might be all they need. He's into scoring position now with a double.
Jason Mott is going to have his work cut out for him here. First pitch coming. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. Soler is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. Now it's cut off, a throw to the plate, and it's a sack fly and an RBI. It's now a 2-0 game. John Jay will dig in with a very important insurance run 90 feet away at third. And here's the first pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground, but a foul ball here, 0-1. He's set, now the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play.
Shut him down now.
He's ready, now the pitch. Oh, here's a line drive into center field. It's a base hit. In to score easily is the runner from third, and the lead will swell to 3 now in the seventh inning. Adam Wainwright will try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. First offering on the way. And this is hit well towards the hole. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit. Matt Carpenter will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first 3 plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
The 1-0 pitch. Lined hard towards short. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Starlin Castro will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. And he's retired, 1 away. Anthony Rizzo will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first 2 plate appearances. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one. Now, people describe this guy as throwing a heavy sinker. Would you guys agree with that assessment?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's hard to explain why that's the case, but it's true. When you run into a guy with a good sinker and lots of movement on it, it just feels like you're hitting a bowling ball. The ball just doesn't go anywhere.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
And even though he's pitching well, this is a part of the order that he's really got to worry about. They can turn a good outing into a bad one pretty darn quickly.
For the shortstop, Peralta. Over to his left. He's up with it. Throw gets him. 2 down. Jorge Soler will stand in. He struck out and popped out in 2 trips. And there's the good fastball that time from Wainwright as he gets ahead 0-1.
You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan...
And hold that thought, as that's a strikeout for route number 3. So the inning will come to an end. Jacob Turner will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. Here it comes. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike 2.
I think he needs to cut down on his swing a bit, get a little more compact, because he ain't going to be touching those fastballs.
And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. Ready with another 0-2. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. The 0-2 once more. Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. The next 0-2. Swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt as they'll need to throw down to first. And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out. Matt Holliday will stand in now, and he's been kept quiet out of the number 3 hole, hitless in his 3 at-bats so far. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. A leap at the wall by Fowler, but he'll come up empty. It's a home run. It's a solo home run for Matt Holliday. And with it, the Cardinals have increased their lead 4-0.
Oh, that's a huge home run right here in the 8th, because that moves the lead to 4 runs now. Of course, a lot can happen between now and the bottom of the 9th, but for the time being, you wonder if they even need to turn to their closer in what would be a non-save situation.
Matt Adams will stand in, and they've been able to hold him in check so far, 0-for-3 to this point.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising that he's been a non-factor in this one, usually a major force in their offense.
First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. The pitch. Grounded fouled off to the right side. Now here's the pitch. And certainly no offer at that one. It's 1-2.
On 0-2, if that's a curveball, a changeup, a sinker, then maybe you get a guy to chase. But it's much easier to lay off a pitch down there when it's a straight fastball.
To the bag with it himself is Rizzo for the out. Yadier Molina will dig in. He walked and later scored last time. Now Molina connects on one here, high and deep out to left field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. One for the Redbirds here, and it comes on this Matt Holliday home run. We'll go to the bottom of the 8th. It's now 4-0 St. Louis. Miguel Montero stands in as he checks his swing here for strike 1. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. Hit hard but fouled off toward the dugout. The 1-2 from Wainwright. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Pitch on the way. Now here's a little tapper down that third base line, and this could be a tough play. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Here's a ball hit foul down the third baseline, so they'll try it again. Sets the 2-2 pitch. Out in front as this is in the air toward deep right field. Therefore, it is Hayward now, one away. Chris Coughlin will dig in, one for two. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. The cutter runs outside, ball one.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch, something to get a base runner and get that guy something else to think about out there.
The 1-1. And this is lifted in the air out to left. Settling under it is Holiday to make the catch, and that's out number two. Javier Baez will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
Now here's the pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard to third. And the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They trail here 4-0.
Leading off for St. Louis.
Johnny Peralta will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth. And the ninth inning will get underway here with a swing and a ground ball out to short. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Colton Wong will stand in here. He's 0 for 2 with a sacrifice to this point. Runs up to bunt here, but he missed it for strike one.
Yeah, and when you're looking to run up and catch him by surprise, you're hoping it's going to be a fastball. Because when you get an off-speed pitch, it really kind of throws your timing off.
Here's a ball for Rizzo over at third. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now. John Jay will get another crack, 1 for 3 thus far. Here's the first offering. Swung on and taken the opposite way out toward deep left center. Fowler is there, and they go down in a hurry here as the side is quickly retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Tommy La Stella will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Now the pitch. Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side. And that's in there, base hit. So that's just how you want to start it here in the bottom of the ninth. Ryan Sweeney will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. He's set, now the pitch. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. Step on the bag for one, and a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
This is a nice play up the middle. You can see this ball takes the shortstop right to the bag, so he'll just step on second and fire on to first for the double play.
Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Throw to first will be in time to record the final out, and the Cardinals get a complete game shutout from their starter as this ball game is over.
Yeah, just two hits were all they could muster off of him. He was in complete control from the start of this game, and he finished it off in style, too.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory.
That left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Comes set. Now the pitch. And, oh, look out! Up and in and nearly took his head off. You worry a little about things snowballing from here?
Well, you know, these are two teams that don't traditionally care for each other too much, so we've seen this go south before.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away. John Jay will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And there's the good fastball from Lester as he jumps ahead. No balls and a strike.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
off the plate. One ball, one strike. One-one on its way from Lester. Fooled him a bit as this is hit high in the air towards right center and shallow. And here's Soler to make the grab, and that will end the inning. Jorge Soler will start things off in the bottom of the second. Here's the first offering. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Now here's the pitch. Boy, that's just about in the catcher's glove there. It's 0-2.
A lot of people think that pitch will burn straight down, but it will work back a little bit towards righties, like that one did right there.
Another 0-2 now from Wainwright. The 0-2 is a breaking pitch taken for a ball, 1-2.
That trying to go front door with that breaking ball started it a little too far inside, though.
Fouled back. Here's another 1-2. Stays alive here as this is fouled off to the right. He'll try again, 1-2. Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number one. So one away here with the bases empty, and stepping in now is the catcher, Miguel Montero. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. Montero waits. Now the pitch. Ah, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2.
Part of the reason why you win 20 games, well, you don't give up the long ball. And Wainwright last year, just 10 home runs allowed in 227 innings. That's the best ratio among starters in the National League.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away. Chris Coughlin will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Now the pitch. Hit hard but fouled off to the left, and that'll keep you honest as a third base coach. We're in the second with the Redbirds holding a 1-0 lead. Breaking ball swung on and grounded to second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Adam Wainwright will turn right around and get us started here. 9-1-2 to start inning number three. Now here's the first pitch. And Lester back to work as this is swung on and missed for the first strike.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
Ani takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two.
Hey, give him credit up there. He's going to take his hacks.
A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2. The 1-2. And this is swung on and missed for strike three. And adding insult to injury, that pitch hit him as well. But there's one away. Matt Carpenter will dig in. He popped out his first time. First pitch coming. Fouled straight back. Here it comes. And look out as this bat shatters on impact. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two. Jason Hayward will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Way off balance hack that time. Good for the first strike.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one. And that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. Down in order go the Cardinals, but they're on top 1-0. Javier Baez will come forward to begin the inning. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
And they're still searching for a base runner. It's been 6 up, 6 down to start the game.
Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, but he will come on strong out there in right and pull this one down for the first out. Tommy La Stella will step in now. Now the first pitch. And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Grounded
so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Adams is over, and he's got it for the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And stepping in now is the catcher, Miguel Montero. And this is going to be a foul ball. Montero waits. Now the pitch. And this is swung on and missed that time by Montero. No balls and two strikes now.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's one and two. And there's the good curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight. Chris Coughlin will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes. Pitch on the way. And you can put those no-hit thoughts away as this is into right field for their first hit of the ball game.
Well, he'd had some high-stress innings here so far and was looking like he turned the corner and was on his way to a much-needed 1-2-3, but he's going to have to get in the stretch here after all.
Grounded foul off to the right. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Yeah, one pitch away now from getting through five shutout innings. And I'll tell you.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Matt Carpenter will get things started here in the top of inning number six. Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. Here's the pitch. Oh, and he can't hold on there as he swings and misses on a pitch in the dirt, and he's down 0-2 now.
There you see one of the best swings in baseball look pretty ugly. That's what this guy can do to you.
Struck him out, but he'll try for first on the drop third strike. And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out. Jason Hayward will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And quickly, two are gone now here in the visitors' half of the sixth. Matt Holliday will stand in, 0-2 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one. Well, for that man right there, only the one run allowed. How discouraging is that when you're pitching your heart out and you're just not getting the support?
Well, the good pitchers really don't let it get to them. They know that it cuts both ways. Sometimes you give up five runs and your guys score you eight. You just have to focus on holding up your end.
And sorry to interrupt, but the play has been made for the third out. Inning over. Tommy La Stella will come in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first five innings have not been particularly kind to them.
And I think that's putting it mildly. Just one hit in these first five innings, they're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Way outside, 1-2. This is offered at in the dirt for strike three. Just needs to make that easy throw to first. Throw on to first is in time to get him. So that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 put out for out number one.
Catcher, John Lester.
John Lester is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one.
And I wish more guys would pitch like this. I mean, look at that pitch count right there. That is really low for this stage of the game, and it's because he's throwing strikes and challenging guys.
Here's the first offering. Dexter Fowler is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
Yeah, that's the put-away curveball.
Now, sorry to interrupt, but that's the third strike and the third out. Side is retired. Cubs are down in order. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Matt Adams will come forward now to begin the seventh inning in what's been a very briskly played ball game here tonight.
That's what happens when you get two starters that are on top of their game. It's been great pitching, great defense, not a lot of base runners, and a very even game through six innings.
Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. 1-1 on its way from Lester. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Real good lateral movement on that two-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that. So just keep on throwing.
Got him. One gone for the Redbirds in the seventh. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. And now a pitch on the way. That's wide, 2-0. Now here it comes. 3-0 now.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
Here it comes, the 3-0. And he won't even have to take the bat off its moorings. A four-pitch walk here.
Now batting.
So a runner at first now with one away. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Johnny Peralta. Closing in on game time at Wrigley Field. The Cardinals and the Cubs, next on the show. It's been 100 years of baseball and counting at this place, and the charm hasn't faded a bit at venerable Wrigley Field in Chicago. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Chicago Cubs. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here for this NL Central Division matchup. I'm joined in the booth by longtime big leaguers Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. Before we get to them, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting St. Louis Cardinals. As manager Mike Matheny will line his guys up this way. On the mound to face these guys, one of the more consistent left-handers around, as you see the numbers there for the former All-Star, John Lester. Matt Carpenter will move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight.
St. Louis, third baseman number 13, Matt Carpenter.
All right.
And he swings on the first pitch as this is popped high into the air on the left side. LaStella is there, and it's a first pitch out to start the ball game. So Lester off to a good start, and with that, let's take a look at the Cubs' alignment on defense. It's brought to us by the folks at Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. And now the second pitch of the inning is in the air to right. There to pull it in is Soler, and there are two away. Matt Holliday will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. First pitch of the at-bat is lifted in the air out to left. Coughlin will wait on it, and he will put it away to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. It's the Cardinals nothing. Cubs coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Now there you see Dexter Fowler as he'll be the one to commence the action in the bottom half of the first. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. Pitch on the way. Swing and a ball sliced foul into the seats down the left field line. Now here it comes. And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one. Starlin Castro will be the batter. First pitch coming from Wainwright. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Now here's the pitch. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. A ball and two strikes now to the 2014 All-Star.
And now, as a hitter, one and two, you've got to be thinking right center field. But take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now, two away. Anthony Rizzo will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. Hit softly to the right side. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Matt Adams will start us off in the second inning, and I believe, Steve, patience ought to be the watchword here.
Yeah, down on three pitches in the first inning. That's making life a little too easy for him out there.
Now Lester's 0-1. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. O-2 now from Lester. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. So the base is empty here with one away. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. On now a ball headed for the alley in right center, and on the first pitch of the at-bat, it's going to find that alley for extra bases. Here's Molina around first. He'll try for two. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Batting six.
So a runner aboard at second here with one away. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Johnny Peralta. Now the first pitch here from Lester. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Lester ready. The 1-0. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. And nobody can get there in time. Base hit. And the run will score as the Cardinals are on the board first. It's 1-0. Colton Wong will stand in with a run in, one out, and one on here in the inning. First offering on the way. Not his best effort that time. It's strike one.
Pretty good speed here coming out of the
fouled off to the right side. The pitch. And a big curveball is in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone. John Lester will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Yeah, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Now he takes something off there as this is skied out to deep center field. Jay is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Matt Holliday will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
The left fielder number seven, Matt Holliday.
Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. And that is a fair ball as this one's heading for the left field corner. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Matt Adams will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now the first pitch here from Lester. Oh, and Montero can't squeeze it as it gets away. But he's safe at first as he gets back in time. One run, two hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. Now Lester's 0-1. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land foul just shy of the wall. 0-2 now from Lester. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now another 0-2.
way outside. One and two.
And you know, down there at third base, he absolutely wants another shot at a ground ball. Something to try and make up for that error.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
And after the error on that previous play, I think he's out there saying, you know what? Why don't I just take care of this guy myself? Good job out there to bounce back with the strikeout.
Now here's the first pitch. Yadier Molina comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Hayes leading towards second.
Lester ready, the 1-0. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Here's the 1-1. And he gets under this one and in fact breaks his bat as this one's popped up. Oh, and he misses it! And the throw will go to second as they get the force out. Johnny Peralta will stand in. An RBI single in his first appearance. Now the first pitch. Hard hit to third. He'll go to Baez at second for the force, and that ends the inning. Dexter Fowler will be the one to lead it off when we come back. Dexter Fowler will stand in to begin their half of the fourth with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ballgame.
And still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
Back on the hill is Wainwright now as he jumps ahead of the leadoff man, nothing and one.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
And he's retired here, one away. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And to this point, these two have topped out at 95 and 91 miles an hour, respectively. Starlin Castro comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. And a good two-strike breaking ball there, but this will wind up missing. It's 1-2.
That big curveball is not an easy one to take on an 0-2 count. That's a great job of holding on.
Here comes a 2-2. And he got him. Anthony Rizzo will stand in here, hoping to pick up his club's first hit in the contest. And this pitch is right down the middle, strike one.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. A scoreless half inning there from Adam Wainwright, and he's got himself a 1-0 lead.
Second baseman, Colton Wong.
First pitch coming. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. And the pitch. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth. John Jay will try it again. He flew out his first time. First pitch to him. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Adam Wainwright will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. That's out to left. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? You bet he does. 11 in a row set down, and the inning is over. Jorge Soler will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about. So.
Here we go, first pitch on the way. And now the bat explodes as this has popped up. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now Lester's 0-1. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Ready now on 1-1. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here's the 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Here he comes on 2-2. Now a rocket deep down the line in left. And this will get by him at third down the line. It's a fair ball.
And the way their starter's throwing, another run here, that might be all they need. He's into scoring position now with a double.
Jason Mott is going to have his work cut out for him here. First pitch coming. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. Soler is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. Now it's cut off, a throw to the plate, and it's a sack fly and an RBI. It's now a 2-0 game. John Jay will dig in with a very important insurance run 90 feet away at third. And here's the first pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground, but a foul ball here, 0-1. He's set, now the pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play.
Shut him down now.
He's ready, now the pitch. Oh, here's a line drive into center field. It's a base hit. In to score easily is the runner from third, and the lead will swell to 3 now in the seventh inning. Adam Wainwright will try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. First offering on the way. And this is hit well towards the hole. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit. Matt Carpenter will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
The 1-0 pitch. Lined hard towards short. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. Starlin Castro will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
Ran one in there as this is hit on the ground towards second. And he's retired, one away. Anthony Rizzo will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one. Now, people describe this guy as throwing a heavy sinker. Would you guys agree with that assessment?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's hard to explain why that's the case, but it's true. When you run into a guy with a good sinker and lots of movement on it, it just feels like you're hitting a bowling ball. The ball just doesn't go anywhere.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
And even though he's pitching well, this is a part of the order that he's really got to worry about. And they can turn a good outing into a bad one pretty darn quickly.
For the shortstop, Peralta. Over to his left, he's up with it. Throw gets him, 2 down. Jorge Soler will stand in. He struck out and popped out in 2 trips. And there's the good fastball that time from Wainwright as he gets ahead 0-1. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan...
And hold that thought, as that's a strikeout for out number 3, so the inning will come to an end. Jacob Turner will be summoned from the bullpen now, as he'll take over to start inning number 8. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. Here it comes. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike 2.
I think he needs to cut down on his swing a bit, get a little more compact, because he ain't going to be touching those fastballs.
And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul.
ready with another 0-2. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. The 0-2 once more. Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. The next 0-2. Swing.